Hello everyone, today we're going to see how to set up Flutter without Android Studio, so we can actually run it without a powerful computer. Well, we are going to see in this tutorial how to set up Flutter, how to install a lightweight emulator, and how to connect it. Now, let's start. So, first of all, we are going to need Visual Studio Code. So you can download it from the official site and follow the instructions. The next thing that we are going to do is follow this guide. Well, in this guide, they are asking us to open Visual Studio Code, navigate to the extensions, and look for Flutter. We are going to install it. And we are going to open the command palette. We are going to look for Flutter new project, select application, and we are going to select where we are going to store our app. So we are going to save it here, and we have to specify a name. I'm going to call it as my first app. Now we are going to do an extra configuration. After we install it, we are going to follow the next setup. We are going to update the boot spec that jumped, which is in the root folder. Also, we are going to copy for the analysis options, and we are going to replace it. And we are all set. The only thing is that we can actually add some code, and we're going to put that into the lib main dart, which is here. Now we are all set. We are going to select one web browser and we're going to run it. Let's wait. And as you can see here, it is running. So now we are going to stop this. And we are going to start with the installation of a lightweight emulator. If you are using Windows, you can download this emulator. It's called LD Player. It's free. So you can download and follow the steps. And after it is done, we are going to open it. It's called LD Player. The option we are going to click in expand, and we're going to go to settings. Here you're going to see it in another language. If you want to change the screen, you can select between tablet, mobile, ultra, and to specify the size. We are going to go to others, and we are going to look for ADB. Here we are going to ensure that it says open connection, and we are going to save it. Now we are going to close it because we don't want it to take our resources. So the next thing is to actually do the process from connecting the emulator with Visual Studio Code. So to do that, we are going to need Java to compile for the mobile. And to do that, we are going to install Java 17 from this website. Also, you can select a higher version, but I recommend you to use the 17. If you have Windows, then you just select here, or otherwise if you have Linux. We are going to save this folder. We are going to open, and as you can see here, it is basically having the SE for Java. Now we are going to create a custom folder, which is going to be in C folder. It's going to be in Java. And here we're going to extract that folder. After that, what we are going to do is that we are going to look for edit system variables, which is this one. We are going to select environment variables and we are going to add a new one, which is going to be Java home. And here we are going to copy this pad and paste it here. Now we are going to look for the pin. We are going to copy it. And we are going to look for the path. We are going to click edit, new, and paste the root. Then okay, and save it. Now we are going to verify that we did it successfully. We are going to press our command R to open this and place C and D. We are going to do java --version. As you can see here, we have the Java 17. Now we are going to close this one. And we already have Java. The next thing that we are going to do is that we are going to add the command line tools. And to do that, we are going to download from here. I am using Windows, so I am downloading this one. We have to accept the agreement and click on download. We are going to save it. And we are going to create a new folder. This folder is going to be here. So we need development and Android SDK. So we are going to go for folder C, right click, new folder. You can actually call this as you want. We are going to specify the root later. So this after this, we are going to create Android SDK. And from here, we are going to unzip that file. I'm going to open this one. I'm going to do right click, extract files. And I'm going to place the root. So it's in C, in development, and under Android SDK. After that, we are going to check C, development, Android SDK, the correct one, and that's it. We are going to copy this under another folder, which is going to be called as tools. We are going to follow this route. So it's going to be under this one. After that, we are going to edit the system variables, which is going to be again edit system environment variables. We are going to do environment variables and we are going to create some news. So to do that, we are going to do import, which is here. Edit, we are going to click in new and we are going to paste the one that is in bin. So we are going to copy this one and we are going to click in new and we are going to paste it. We just save everything and then we are going to open again the command line. We are just going to verify that we can access to SDK manager. So now we are just going to run all of the installations that are here. You can press just Y if needed. Going to add the next variables. So to do that again, we're going to open edit system variables and we are going to create two. which is going to be the Android Home, and then another one, Android SDK root. So we are creating it. It's going to be Android Home, and it is going to be here. And we are going to create another one, which is going to be Android SDK root, and we are going to paste the same code. Now what we are going to do is to modify our path, so we are going to look for it. We are going to click in edit, and we are going to add this. So we are going to add this one. The emulator, the tools, and platform tools. And let's save everything. Now we are going to restart Visual Studio Code so these changes can have the effect. Now I'm going to close it. And now we're going to open again Visual Studio Code. And we are going to do some updates. If you run Flutter Doctor --verbose, you can see what are the default paths. So we are just going to copy. And we are going to see what are our paths. Well, as you can see here, those are our paths. Now we are going to first configure our Java. We are going to paste it. Now we are going to configure our Android SDK. And we are going to restart again. Now let's see again with Flutter Doctor. And we're going to see if there is any other error. And as you can see here, everything is good. So now we are just going to restart. And we are just going to make sure that our emulator is being recognized. To do that, we are going to open our folder. We are going to go to Android SDK Platform Tools, and we are going to open the CMD here. We are going to run ADB, and we are going to place devices. So we are just going to wait that this starts. And we are going to check it. So now it is working. In order to update the size, we are going to do configuration size, and we are going to select any of them. Alright, so we are going to check again the devices, and now it's being recognized. So now we can just open Visual Studio Code. We'll select our emulator. And we're going to run it. This may take a few moments, so let's be patient. Well, as you can see, here we have our application running in Android. Well, thank you for watching. Please feel free to comment.